For those who may not be aware, the fresh produce industry has been involved in an industry-wide initiative for the last couple of years, at least since 2009, trying to find ways to reduce auto fatigue in the produce industry. And this has been a major initiative, including not only suppliers, but all the different points along the fresh produce supply chain, right up through the retail and food service buyers that Christian's been referring to. This GAP Auto Harmonization Initiative was designed to see if we could find a way to generate a single audit checklist. This was the vision of the harmonization, and this vision was developed by a steering committee comprised primarily of food service and retail buyers. All of the major produce buyers in the U.S. are participating in this initiative, and this was their vision of harmonization: to develop a harmonized food safety standard, checklist for GAP audits, and a globally acceptable auditing process as necessary to protect consumers from potential hazards that may contaminate produce during the growing stages of produce, and also to build efficiencies into the supplier audit process. This is a very long vision, but what they were trying to say is one audit by any credible third party, acceptable to all buyers. And this is really the goal of the harmonization initiative. It's the goal of suppliers who are being audited. It's also the goal of buyers who are requesting those audits. I'm very pleased to be able to tell everybody that this initiative that's been going on for a couple of years has succeeded in finalizing a checklist. The checklist is for field operations and harvesting processes, and this was completed in July 2011. And it was completed by harmonizing many of the most popular and used audit checklists that are out there in the U.S. today, including Global GAP and USDA and NSF and a number of the other major audit bodies and audit processes. So this standard has now been completed, and it is ready to be used. However, as we know, an audit is not limited to just the audit standard. The audit process, how that audit standard is interpreted, how it is used during an audit, and how the auditors are trained, all of that goes into the audit process. And the Harmonization Initiative expressly decided to work only on the audit standard, not to get involved in the audit process. Every audit organization that's out there today has their own audit process, and they have customers who believe in that audit process. And it wasn't the goal of the Harmonization Initiative to change that. We wanted to come up with a single audit standard, but we believe that audit standard can be used with a multitude of audit processes. And what we saw was a clear opportunity to combine the harmonized standard with the Global GAP audit process for use in the United States. Global GAP obviously has a globally accepted process, and there are many buyers within the United States and outside that accept and believe in the Global GAP audit process. So the idea was to use the harmonized standard together with that widely accepted audit process. In order to enable that, United Fresh agreed to serve as host for a U.S. National Technical Working Group that would help facilitate the getting the harmonized standard into the Global GAP process. However, doing that is not as easy as one might think. It's sort of like fitting the square peg of the harmonized standard into the round hole of the Global GAP audit process. And in the last 6 months, we've determined this is not really an easy thing to do, but we do believe it is doable. Our process was to convene a national technical working group from all U.S. stakeholders. Anyone who is interested in participating in this was welcome to come to the meeting. And over the last 6 months, these individuals, representing many companies across the supply chain, have been working to compare the harmonized standards with the version 4 Integrated Farm Assurance Global GAP standards. And what we found was that there were a lot of similarities, a lot of overlap, a lot of the same things being looked at by both the Global GAP standards and the harmonized standard, but there were differences as well. And our goal has been to identify what those differences are and find a way to allow the Global GAP process to use the harmonized standard. We are in the middle stages, I would say, of developing a U.S. national interpretation guideline that would enable that to occur. And we expect over the next month or so to finalize that draft to a point that we'll be able to submit it to the Global GAAP Secretariat for consideration as the U.S. standard. So that is a very short explanation of what we're doing and how we're planning to do it. There will be a lot more detail provided to those folks who come to Atlanta for the Global GAAP meeting in October.